Hi everyone, I wanted to give you a setup of my Filofax Malden. This is the personal size in the Ochre, and I'm sure like many of you, you've seen a million setup videos, but I wanted to do this one specifically because I'm using it in a way that I haven't really seen before, and that is as a couples planner. It's a shared planner with my husband and me. I do all of the writing and the setting up and that kind of stuff, but we are only in this one when we're together. And also I'm using the Franklin Covey planner inserts, the 7 habits, and I really haven't seen a lot of people using those as well. So those are my main reasons. And then for the planner itself, I always like to give a little backstory because I want to know kind of the why people are using their planners and how they're using them and how that all came about. So a few reasons for this specific planner is that number one, I have shared in the past that my husband has a super duper crazy schedule. And I'm not even talking about necessarily just out of town or in town. When he is in town, his schedule's also nuts. I live with the man and I can barely keep up with him. So that was one of the issues. And I do have that written down on our monthly family calendars and our weekly family calendar, but I always just throw those away. Another reason is that my husband has been asking slash pleading slash begging me to get more involved with the business, especially the financials and the organization. And for many reasons that hasn't happened, but it is happening now. And I realize that that has been something that I have been needing to do is get involved. Also, he is more of a big picture thinker. If you saw my top down versus bottom up planning series, he's very much a top down planner, which is that goals and vision kind of thinking. And I am much more of a bottom up type of person. I'm very detailed. I'm sure you can tell by my videos. So that can either be a very contradictory or a complementary with an E, the complementary way of thinking. And we're going for the latter. And then probably the final reason is that, like many of you, I feel like just across the board, last year was just a really rough year for many of us, and we have been no exception. Fortunately, our children all had wonderful years, but both, not in our marriage, but both personally, my husband and myself probably had one of the most difficult years that we've ever had. My husband is a very positive person, and even he said that it was a really bad year, so you know it's bad when happy people are saying that. And so anyway, that's why me being the paper planner person that I am, I was just brainstorming how we could figure out how to change things, right? Because if you keep doing the same things and expecting different results, that's the definition of insanity. And so we just kind of looked at each other at the end of last year and just said, something has to change. We just cannot keep having these kinds of years, especially the kind of years that we had last year. So in the beloved Filofax Malden, I really, really love this. Initially, when I set this up, I thought I was going to be changing out my binders every month, perhaps at least every season, because I do like some variety. But once I set this up, I really don't think I'm going to change. It may if I get super bored with this cover, but I am really loving just this entire setup. So let's go ahead and start with the outside. And right here, I've got, this is the progressive task list from the Franklin Covey system. It's a cardstock. This marks my month. You probably can't see this very well because it's transparent, but this is their page finder pouch bookmark that they have with the weekly compass in it. And that marks the day because these are daily inserts. And then this right here is a file folder clip tab. And that is going to have our word of the year on it. And then the very last one right here is another progressive task list, and that marks our goals. So what our thinking was is that we kind of just needed to have what we're calling a recalibration meeting every single day. And that's really probably what many of you do. It's just that we're actually writing that down and going into a little bit more detail. And so just recalibration, I think that's the perfect word for it. I know that's a very long word, but we're kind of calling it now our recal meeting. And we just meet at the end of every day, usually at bedtime. We're just getting ready for bed. This sits on my nightstand. I am the only one who writes in it because, you know, he's Mr. Technology. He doesn't write. And it really only takes us, I would say, anywhere from 2 minutes. I think our longest one so far has been like 20, and that's when we really had to hash some things out and think about some things. So probably what, like I said, what everybody does if you are in a relationship, but we just needed, because of the nature of his profession, his line of work, and his position and everything like that, it just, he just has so much more to take care of. And I frankly don't, I don't work well with those kinds of things. He has a million spreadsheets, and you guys know I'm a paper planner person, so I need it written down. So anyway, let's go move on with the setup. Here is from this side. So these are the Franklin Covey 7 habits. So as you can see, and this is one of the reasons why when I set it up, I'm like, I don't think I'm going to change, because isn't this just a gorgeous pairing? These kind of have, I think they're called grays, if I'm not mistaken. I'm not an artist, but they've got just these gray tones to them, which has like a brown undertone, which, again, I'm not an artist, I don't understand that. But the green, the brown, this is a taupe color, and this is a gray. I think they just, the tabs look absolutely stunning with the Malden. Now, a little information about the Malden. If you're unfamiliar, obviously Malden is a European brand, and from Filofax. Filofax is probably the smallest inserts on the market, and I'm talking the width, because all of the inserts this size, this is like a personal size, a compact in the Franklin Covey, and then a Bible size in the Asian brands. They're all the same height, but Filofax is shorter this way, so the width, and then Franklin Covey, on the other hand, are the widest ones on the market. So the tabs, I'm feeling them, and they're more flush than they're looking on camera with the outside of the cover. That may bother some people, and as you can see with, we'll get to the pen loop in that situation in just a minute, but this has not bothered me at all. But it does come out to the edges of that, just because the Franklin inserts are the widest ones. The difference between Filofax and Franklin is 1 inch, which is a huge amount of real estate, especially in a planner this size. All right, let's go ahead and open it up. Pretty basic here, as you can imagine, since it's not just mine. In the zipper pocket, I think a lot of people struggle with what to put in here. It is set up, obviously, as a wallet, so you would normally put your coins or something in here. But I have my pens in here. So the pen loop is pretty unanimously something that people struggle with in the Malden. It is all leather, which I really like, but it is thin. I do have plenty of pens that will fit in here. But with the Franklin inserts, as you can see, the pen gets in the way. It does work. I've used probably 3 different pens at this point, just trying some out. If you are careful, you can get pens to work. You just have to make sure that the tabs don't get messed up, because that's something that would bother me. And I did try that for a while, but this zipper pocket just seems to work out the best for my pens. So let me go ahead, and this is where I'm going to start geeking out, because I am a complete pen nerd. So I've got 3 that I keep in here. The first one is one of the Sakura glazes. This is a pen I do not like at all, but it's white and it's a 0.8, and I use that on my monthly calendar pages to write some quotes. I'll show you in just a minute. So I keep that in here, just trying to use that one up to get to my other ones. And then I've got my beloved Pentel 8, which is the standard 8 colors, not any of the other ones. And this I am only using for the yearly fold out, and I will get to that in a second as well. And then the last one, this is my current pen that I'm using, and it's the Coletto Lumio. These pens have since been discontinued, and they have now have a new and improved line called the 1000. It's basically the Lumio, which is kind of the higher end Coletto. I say that in quotes, because high end with a Coletto is kind of a misnomer. They really are not that expensive, but it does have like the metallic barrel. I do have a 4 color. Now this is, right now, okay, backtrack a little bit. My situation is I have one of my children living with me for a few months until she goes back to school. So because of that, I did need her color in here. So at this point in my life, I really don't think I can change my color coding system, because it's so ingrained in my brain. So here's what I have in here. Black is anything combined with, whether it's family or just me and my husband. Light blue has always been my daughter. That's her favorite color. one of my favorites as well, but she had it first. Then green has always been my husband, and then red is me because that's my all-time favorite color. I thought I would make it easy on myself and just use kind of like the Hobonichi pen or just one of the pre-fills, which always comes with the three colors of blue, red, and black. You guys, could not make myself use blue for my husband. I'm like, he's not blue. He's not blue. He's green. So that's why I had to go to something like a Coletto. And so I did use the three barrel Coletto or another equivalent pen for a while until my daughter, like I said, her situation. So now I'm at four colors right now. And then when she leaves, because it's not if, when she leaves, I'll go back to a three barrel. So that's the situation. I also will say that with my pens, okay, let me show you this. So with the pens, this does fit in here. It's a tight fit, but the Coletto will fit in here. Actually, this one probably won't because it's four barrel. Then what I have done a lot in the past when I've been using my Malden is I just hook it on this back pocket. So as you can see, it works out completely fine. I've never had any issue with any rubbing or anything, but as you can see on the pen loop I have right there with the pen clips. So I was just hooking it there for a while, and this is what I'm talking about, where you just, it can close, but you just have to make sure that your pen, you see how it kind of like, it messes with the tabs a little bit. So like I said, it can work. I just didn't want to have to be, you know, worrying about my pen and my tabs all the time. So that's where I keep them. We are in this once a day. Like I said, we have missed only a few days, and that is only because one or both of us, not both of us, but one of us was out of town. When we're both out of town or we're both in town, that's not really been a problem. So then you can see right here, I don't really have a lot in here. These are just some little sticky notes I'm trying to use up. And I'm just going to, at the end of the month, use these to flag something that I need to, in my notes section, if I need to compile it or transfer it or something. And then I've just got regular sticky notes, post-its right there, the 1.5 by 2s, and then another, some more page flags right here. I love page flags. And then I've just got an old gift card. It's hard to see, but there is black right here. That's our color coding system. Red for me, green for my husband, and black. My daughter's never really out of town or anything like that, so I didn't really need to have that for her. And then I've just got more page flags back here because I love them. These are just the Dollar Tree ones, the transparent ones. Okay, we'll get to the setup now. And really, this planner is set up exactly like the Franklin system. I did not change anything, so this may be not very exciting. I did buy the year fold out, and I haven't filled this out. I started to, and then I really just need to give myself a little bit more time to think about this. This front part is going to be only for my husband's schedule, and that's how crazy his schedule is. So this is what I'm talking about. He is either in town or out of town. He could be off-site when he's in town. He could be in the office. He could work a half day at the office, half day at home, all day at home. He could work a half day at work and come home and not work, and vice versa, be at home and only work a half a day. He takes days off the majority of the time. I'm saying 99% of the time, if he takes a day off, he ends up working. So part of this too is to help him actually have some vacation days and some time off. So I won't go into any more. I'm debating whether I want to have a color for every single one of those, or if I stick to his color and just do like stripes or something like that. Anyway, I really need to think that, but obviously I won't have any more than eight colors, which is the Pentel colored pencil. So that's the front section. And this is also going to help me at the end of the year. I always wonder how many days he was actually out of town, just that kind of thing. It just would be helpful and interesting to know. And then on the back is going to be all of our personal things, like he and I are going to be working on some things together. So front side is business, back side is personal for he and I. Then I just have the special days, holidays, and the year at a glance on two pages. And I think these came with the actual planning pages, or they come with the starter pack, which I've done videos on those. I've also done flip throughs of these, so I won't go into tons of detail. Then I have it exactly set up like it came. So here's the planning calendar, and these black tabs are the rest of the tabs. The colored tabs are the actual planning pages. These dividers are extremely boring, as you can see. I really do want to put some quotes or something on there, which I think I will do sooner than later. But the very first one, all I've done so far is I literally have, I think, three or four of each of these post-its. I love when things are labeled or automatically label themselves. So see, there's some tasks that I need to get done. And obviously these are some phone calls that I need to make. Then you start into the planning pages. And when I did my review and flip through of these, it's the same thing. It hasn't really gone away. I don't really understand what these seven habits, these black and white pictures, and they're very nice pictures, but they're so serene. It just seems a little contradictory to have these kinds of very relaxing pictures in a planner that's supposed to make you super productive. All these pictures make me want to do is put on my sweatpants and, you know, jump into bed or watch a movie or something. So I'm just going to have to get over those. These are set up a little bit different than the normal Franklin Covey, which I really do like. I'm trying to pull some out here. But normally they have let me show you. I don't know if this will fit in, but normally they have an index at the front, and always in, when I've used these inserts before, I've always just used these as a financial tracker. And then on the back, they've got this really great page, huge, the master task list, both personal and business or professional. And I've always used it that way and I've loved it. And so I don't know why these seven habits aren't set up that way. I really would prefer that. Okay, so here is the month. Now, if you saw my review, you know that these are actually 2016 inserts. And so all I have done is, let me get to one that I haven't done yet. So it has the year right here, 2016. And all I did is took my fountain pen, or any black pen actually you can use, and I just colored in the 2016, so that wasn't noticeable. You can see that these dates aren't very obtrusive anyway. And then here's the pen that I use. It's the 0.8, and you can see the difference between a 0.8 and then down here is a 0.3. I have 0.3 refills in there. And I just use the 1/4 inch Avery dots, and I just renumbered the month there. And I just, down here at the bottom, I just crossed out. I think in the past, something like this would have really, really annoyed me and bothered me, but maybe I'm just maturing or progressing in my planning life, but I'm totally fine with this. It doesn't bother me at all. Plus, I think there's so many more options on the market now for undated planners, or if you need to change the dates. It also had 16 over here, and I just put 17 right there. I started kind of doing goals for the month here. We haven't honestly had time to sit down and do our progressive task list, but this is going to be exactly what it is meant for, a progressive task list. So you move this from month to month, and it's just a running list, basically like a brainstorming list of all the things that you need to get done. I started using a few stickers, and I just put these on like yesterday, and that's because I'm trying to use up some stickers, but I don't really need to use these. If I don't end up putting them on a month, I'm completely fine. I also put payday stickers. Any planner that I'm using, the monthly view always relates to that specific planner. So I do not duplicate every single bit of my monthly planner for each one of my planners. So obviously this being a couple's planner with my husband and me, these are things that only relate to he and me. Is that correct English? He and I? Oh goodness. I'm getting tired apparently. Okay, so that is the monthly view. As you can see, not too much on the monthly, and it's going to stay that way. It's just this basic overview there. Here's the back of the pages. So It's kind of condensed from what I just showed you, where it's got an index right here and the task list, personal and business, which is fine. But I, like I said, I would have preferred to have it like their normal inserts were. Then you have a huge index page, which starts on the actual, it's on the backside of the actual daily pages. So let me start, I'm trying to see where I should start to show you, because I don't want to show you everything, but I will do a quick flip through here just so you can see how the pages end up. So here's the color coding, the red, the green, and the black, and just putting the appointment schedules, anything that's set in stone. The personalized daily task list, I have the me on the top, red, green for my husband, and then black at the bottom for anything that relates to both of us. I started putting my daughter's work schedule in here. Let me go back just a minute. First, I was putting it up here and I was like, well, that doesn't really make sense. I should put that on the actual timeline. And so that's when I started putting her here. It may be hard to see, but this is blue and this is green. It may not show up very well on camera. And then here is today. So here is the weekly compass that fits into their page finder. I've said it before, I'll continue to say it again. This is my absolute favorite product from Franklin Covey. And then I'm just using this pretty much what it's intended for. It needs to be a little bit more organized, but he and I do have some of the shared, they call them rolls or rocks. We do have some of them that are the same and then some that are specific for each of us. And really this planner is just to help us kind of just be more cohesive and for me to know exactly what he's doing and the things that I'm working on. And we can just help each other like, hey, how did things go today? Did you get everything done that you wanted to? And then on the back, this notes is, I started using this for kind of this planner, like everything that I wanted to do, kind of the setup things or things I wanted to buy, that kind of thing. So you can see that it's really working. I was hoping that it would. Let me show you on the dailies. It had right here the actual, the day, and then over here, but I didn't feel like I needed to put stickers on all of them. So as you can see, it's just scribbled out. They also had the year. I'm scribbling out the year a month at a time. So I will be doing February shortly, but it's so, as you can see, it's so tiny. You can easily just ignore that. So what I did with these, I had a couple different options that I thought about. The Erin Condren date dots I thought might be good, but these are specifically for the month. They were, I think these are, let me go to February. These are 1/4 inch. I think these are about 3/8 of an inch. I don't know if you can see where the line is on there because of the glare. You can kind of see right there, but they are, that 1/8 of an inch does make a huge difference. And so these ended up not working, which that was kind of a bummer. And then my favorite things, which I've shown you before, these stickabilities from My Paper Studio. These are actually transparent and they wouldn't work because they are transparent. I needed something that would actually cover up the day right here. And as you can see, those would probably work, but they were also a little bit too big. So what I found, which was a great option, was the stickers from Create 365. This is the productivity pack. And they had some stickers in here. I think they're more towards this way. There we go. They're this page right here. So these are all the days of the week. So this is what I used on the weeklies right here. And you can see how many there are. This ended up being about 2 months and a little bit more. It's kind of between 2 and 3 weeks if you want to have an idea on how long that would last. So I don't think this is going to be a permanent long time solution for the entire year, but I had those. And so that's what I used up until March. And then I'll go on to something else, but I really liked those. And then for the Avery, it's the 5795, the 1/4 inch dots. They have 4 different colors. And so I'll be changing up the color. Like obviously March was green, and they do have some fluorescent ones that include, I think pink and orange are the only ones that they do. Also have a yellow and a green, but I didn't need that. So anyway, moving on, I have 3 months. I was going to show you how much this took up. So here is the planner. So these are the actual planning pages, the 3 months. I have all of the year tabs in here, so all of the months in here, but only 3 months of the dailies. That is a Franklin suggestion, is that you basically have past, present, and future. So the past month, the current month, and then the next concurrent month. Since I started this in January, I don't have that yet. So in at the end of when I start March is when I'll take out January. And what I was thinking about doing on this back page, so here's the end of the daily pages. So it's got this notes page right here, which we normally use for the day, and then the business expenses on the back. This is another change with this, the seven habits inserts here. I think I will probably do a synopsis of all of what we talk about with the business on this page, and then compile all of my notes. Hopefully it will fit on just one page, because I don't like to keep things. I've told you that before. I don't archive. I recycle or throw away. So I really, if I have to keep something, I only want to keep one page. So I'm going to try and keep it down to that, because even the back of the monthlies, it's kind of awkward because it's on the back of the page. You know what I mean? So it's, I would prefer to just have this one. So that is my intention there. Then moving on, I have this set up, like I said, exactly. Here's the planner guide. So this is the Franklin system, which I really like. I've said it before. They've got the best system on the market. The values and mission statement, I've ended up with two of these because I ordered a starter pack, and then you always get one with your inserts that you order. My husband and I are both going to do this. So as you can probably imagine, there's so much of this planner I will not be able to share. So we are planning on doing that in the next week or two. This is the cardstock beginning of the Seven Habits. And so I put this in here because it just kind of briefly explains it. And here's the contract you're supposed to sign and commit to it. So this just kind of separates those two. Here is the goals page. And this is, I wanted to show you about these because these are amazing. I cannot remember. I can see her face in my mind. I will link her down below. She's the only one I've ever seen that has used these, and she introduced me to these. I'm giving her all the credit. She's a genius. You know, you see ideas on channels that you watch and you're like, that's a great idea. This one was like, okay, that rocked my world. Rocked my world. I had to run out and buy these. These are the Threshold brand, which they're the Target brand, and they are right there by the all the Nate Berkus stuff. File folder clip labels. These are gold or brass. I don't know which one they call them, but that's what these look like. You get six, and they're $4.99 for six, which is a little, you know, obviously a little bit pricey, but they're metal. And this is the back of them if you want to have the barcode, if you're looking, searching for those. But this is why I like them. They're extremely durable. They can fit on one single page and clip on there. You can either use them like this, where it's a clip like this, or you can just use the clip like that. So it's great. So obviously they're made, like it says, for the file folders, but I love the way that she used these, and I'm using these as well too. She used hers for different priorities. And I also, with the way my brain works, I'm like, you know, I ended up getting another pack because that just made more sense to me to have 12 in case I ever wanted to use these for monthly tabs on any of my planners. So that is, this is our goals page. So that's what this marks. Okay, you guys know I've had a word of the year probably for like the past 5 or 6 years. So this was the first year I brought it up to my husband. He liked the idea. We brainstormed about it, and I haven't written this in yet because I haven't figured out how I wanted to do it. But our word of the year, he's okay with me sharing that our word of the year is progress, and that's our word together. So when I liked this idea, because before I even open up the planner, I've got our word of the year that will remind me right there. And it's just one of those things to have it just in the forefront of your mind every time you look at your planner. That actually didn't come off by itself. I knocked that off. Okay, so in our goals section, I have extra weekly compass pages, and they come in the two like this, and they are perforated right here and right here. And so this is enough for the month. I have another progressive task list. This actually is what I showed you, which marks the goals. We haven't started doing all the details of our goals yet. And I mentioned this also, I'll mention it again because I'm hoping Franklin and Covey will eventually listen. These goal planning pages, I really like them. I got 3 with my starter pack and 3 with my inserts. These, unfortunately, are only available in their classic, which is their A5 equivalent size. I don't know why they're not available in smaller sizes, so I have to be very, very careful about what I'm going to use these for, possibly use a friction, erasable pen, something like that, because I only have 6 total and I don't want to order another starter pack and I can't order just the planning pages themselves. But that's the goal section. In the finance section, I just have a few of those pages that came with the sample sheet. Now, obviously, you guys know I'm huge into finances, and then with business finances, there's no way I can ever fit anything like that in here. But this is just going to be a nice overview synopsis of the finances, do kind of net worth kind of things, both personally and with the business. And the budget's got a budget, and then the monthly expense tracker, which I probably will use those not very often at all. I'll definitely probably use more of the year at a page there. Key information, I only have the website tracker in here. And as you can imagine, me being married to Mr. Technology, just think of what our passwords are compared to like normal people's. So it's crazy. And there's no way I can remember these. So I will be I don't think I'll put all the passwords in here, like the whole thing. I think I'll probably just put the password hints because that is what I need the most. And the most important thing I need to know is how to get into my husband's computer if, heaven forbid, anything happens to him. Then this is where it's also a little bit different than the Franklin inserts. The 7 habits, you actually get a tab. And this is the synopsis of the book, which is amazing. I don't know if I mentioned, but I'll mention it again if I did. But we're reading the 7 habits together. We've read the book, both of us separate, but we're reading it together. Again, it's just more of like we just need to change some things up and to refocus. And so I really like that in here. If the normal inserts from Franklin Covey, you will get a 1 through 5. I've seen a lot of people use these for different projects, and then the number one will be the most important project that they're working on. That's probably my favorite idea. How I'm using this is because this is more of a business type of planner with my husband. I'm using these for different quarters. That's kind of how my mind thinks because there's 4. This is a yearly planner. So this will be Q1 through 4. Both in the professional and the personal goals that we want to do for the quarter. And then the monthly goals, I'll put back on the monthly. But I have the seasons paper in here. This is also Franklin brand. So here's winter, spring, summer, and autumn. If you haven't seen those before, very pretty papers. I love the spacing of the line is very small. So those are great. So I will just be putting some things in there for each quarter. Last but not least is the address and phone section. And again, this is going to be just professional things. There are certain contacts with my husband's profession that I need to know of. He has it all, but I don't have them in my phone. So like I said, heaven forbid something happened to my husband. I need to get a hold of a few key people. And so that's what this will all be. And then at the very, very back, I just have the 7 habits, again, Franklin brand of note pages. And I said that these don't really speak to me. The picture stays the same and they don't change color. They don't have any of the 7 habits quotes on here. So that's kind of a bummer. I think I forgot to mention, if you haven't seen my other video, that with the inserts, they have one of the habits at the bottom and then a quote that relates to it. It alternates. It starts with the overview, goes through each one of the 7 habits, and it repeats 8 times. So January is not just all about habit 1 or the overview. I do really like that, and we do try and read at least the quote every single day on that. So it's been working out super great. I have just an Avery 2-pocket folder on the back of here. A lot of people have complained, and I agree, these are really, really sharp on this edge. So I just took my scissors. You probably can't even see, but I just took my scissors and rounded it just the tiniest bit so it doesn't poke the Malden. And I just have those very basic calendar stickers in here. I don't think I'm going to use the majority of these probably for the year, but there are a few ones that I want to use. And in the back, I just have some of those Avery standard tiny rectangles. And then here's the Avery dots in the very back. So it's been working really great. If nothing else, I can see that my husband's stress levels are going down, and that's just because we're communicating and he knows that I know what's going on. So if nothing else, that's been worth having this planner. I will say that because I'm going back to pens now, I will say that if you've seen my fountain pen video, you know I'm matching like my inks and my fountain pen barrels. I'm kind of doing the same thing with my planner, and I have a law of attraction planner that's my personal goals planner for this year. And in there it has, you know, your goals and then your reward. I kid you not, I'm sure you're not surprised that every single one of my rewards has to do with office supplies. So one of my goals was to set this up and to have the meetings with my husband. And so my reward for that is going to be new pens, because I want to have brown pens. Shockingly, I don't have any brown pens in my collection, even though this Coletta right here is, they call it champagne, but it really looks gold. And this would work fine, but you know, I'm a planner girl and I'm obsessed with pens. I'll just own it. So what I ended up doing is ordering the newest version of this, which is the Coletta, like I've said, Coletta 1000 in the metallic brown barrel. And I did order the four, which is, it only is available in that actually. The 1000 line has the four barrels. And then I also ordered, because like I said, I'll either need a three barrel or a four barrel. I ended up ordering the metallic brown, and this is the Uni Style Fit Meister. This is a metallic metal body, which I really like. The Coletto is kind of half plastic, half metal. This is an actual metal pen, which I really like. I prefer that, the heavier type of pen. It's just a gorgeous, stunning pen. So that's kind of my reward, because my husband doesn't care, but my reward for sticking with this planner. It's worked out really well. We'll continue to use it. We actually are starting to not that we didn't before, but we look forward to just kind of having that touch base recalibration meeting every single night. So there you have it. I realize this is really long, but I hope that this has at least sparked some ideas or given you some things to think about in your own personal life. Thanks for watching, you guys, and I will talk to you again soon.